When we first start composting, we are surprised and shocked at all the different living forms of bugs that appear in our compost pots in a few days. Some of us are amazed and some of us are scared to see these creatures scurrying away as we check our compost, especially if we are composting in our balconies or indoors and we worry that they may harm us in some way or cause some disease. Personally, I have always been fascinated as to how all of these magically appear. In today's video, let's take a peek into the fascinating and hidden lives of these compost assistants that help us create wonderful black gold from our kitchen scraps that is so precious for our plants. When I open up my compost pot, this is what I usually see. There's a lot of activity going on, different kinds of bugs, and small and big. They're walking around furiously, and you will be able to see white mites, you will be able to see red mites. You also see the sow bugs, also called as roly poly or pill bug or the potato bug. You may see millipedes, beetles, spiders. And if you have a worm setup nearby, the worms are attracted to the decaying matter, and you'll see red wigglers also, even though you have not put them in there. So there's a lot of life going on in the compost, and these are all our compost assistants. They're helping in the breakdown of the food scraps. Once this breakdown is complete, we get our black gold or compost. In my compost pots, the first bugs that I see are usually the white mites. These look like white dots that are moving very fast, and I usually see them on watermelon peels. They will be present even on others, but whenever I have put watermelon peels, they are the first one to arrive. And there are white mites, and I have also seen red mites, and these are very different from spider mites, so there is no need to worry on that account. So these are black soldier fly larvae, and I saw these the very first time many years ago under my worm bin. I wondered, what in the world are these? And then after asking a few friends, I realized that these are black soldier fly larvae, and this is one bug that you want very badly in your composting system. These are what I call composting trucks. They are so efficient going through the food. A lot of people rear them, just like we have composting worms. People have setups for black soldier fly larvae for waste management systems, and even though they look ghastly when they are at work, they really are so good. They don't spread disease. In fact, they help prevent disease by preventing the multiplication of our regular maggots that houseflies produce. And people actually have black soldier fly larvae farms. Here you can see them going crazy over this rotting guava. The adult, the black soldier fly comes in and lays eggs, and then the larvae are what we see here. I also saw some of them as white, so it's probably some phase of their life cycle. And when they are done, actually I've seen so many of them exiting the compost pot, and I was wondering what it is, and apparently they need to leave that place and get out to move to the next phase of their life cycle. This is one bug that you want, and when you see them out of the pot, that is when many people panic that they're going to come into our house and harm us. That is not the case. These are really a good bug to have on your side. I think the worst ones for me are these horrendous grubs. I don't find it difficult handling worms. If you've seen my vermicompost videos, you know that I don't need gloves to work in my worm bin, and even in the soil when I'm working in my grow bags, these guys, they are just horrible. This is the only one that I don't like at all, and I find great pleasure in feeding them to the crows. They catch them mid-air and it gives me great joy. They're just horrible and they wiggle in your hands and you get the worst feeling ever. Here is the parent. This is called the dung beetle, and these are flying insects. So I never put cow dung or cow slurry or any of that in my compost pots, but these guys are always there in the cool down compost. You know, they don't come in the at the beginning, but they're there midway, and they are good composters. They go through the scraps very well. If you remember, I even have a video where I had kept a bag full of leaves and these guys had composted the entire bag of leaves into their castings. So I'll put a link to that video. Just horrendous. Now these lovely fungi appear when there is a lot of organic decaying matter, and fungi, especially the beneficial ones, they are a very important part of the soil food web, a wonderful part of the ecosystem of the soil. So if you see these fungi from time to time in your compost pot, nothing to worry, just don't try to sample them. This video is not meant to scare away people from composting. This is just to show you what kind of bugs you can expect in your composting system, and they are all good. They are all compost assistants, and I just don't like the grubs. The rest are all welcome. So I hope you enjoyed this video and are not discouraged from composting. It's quite a fascinating ecosystem and life that is going on in the compost. If we try to look at it from another point of view, it's really fascinating. Happy gardening!